Here, we have an electrically actuated gripper arm assembly for an underwater remotely operated vehicle. It may be used for exploration or salvage operations, and depending on the mission, we may want to use a different style of gripper finger. So first, let's see what other gripper finger designs we have in our vault. Here we see there's a number of different designs available to us, and I like this gripper finger experiment A. So let's open it up to verify that that's the one we want. That looks great. So back here in the assembly, before we replace that gripper finger, let's get a better idea of the mechanism design and the assembly mates that this finger has. So we can click on this guy and say, let's see the mates. We can view with mates, and I love it. Notice that only those components who are mated to the gripper finger show up. And as I select each of the items in my list box, it highlights who the players are in each of these mates, such as a concentric mate and a with mate, and in this case, a tangent mate. Furthermore, we can pick on it and get this nice call out, and we can even edit the mate if we so desire. So now we have a little better understanding of what the mate scenario is with that gripper finger, and we're ready to replace the finger component. And that's as easy as a right click, and then the shortcut menu will replace the component. We'll grab the gripper finger that I had selected or taken a look at before, but I want you to notice that we can browse our way across our hard drive, across our PDM vault, across our 3D experience vault, across our network. We can grab parts and even an assembly to replace the part right now that we're interested in replacing. In our case, I'm going to say let's replace the gripper finger in the assembly with the one that I just picked as the alternative. I want you to notice that I have some really granular controls. So I can tell SOLIDWORKS whether I only want one instance replaced, or if I'd selected multiple instances, or if I say replace all of them, it'll replace them all throughout the whole assembly, sub-assembly structure. Furthermore, I can get a little preview, and if there are configurations in the original component and in the replacement component, SOLIDWORKS will select the correct configuration. And then finally, you'll notice that we are asking SOLIDWORKS to reattach the mates in the copied component. We all know that works sometimes. Let's see how we did here. Well, the gripper fingers were replaced, but notice that we have a little problem with our assembly mates. Here in the left pane of SOLIDWORKS, it tells us that SOLIDWORKS doesn't know what the replacement entities are for the various bits of geometry for the concentric and the width mates, etc. This little preview window shows us the geometry used for the concentric mate. And oftentimes folks miss this little toolbar that is really handy. It allows us to isolate the components that use that mate. So now I can simply zoom in, and the workflow, the action is you pick the replacement geometry in the new component that represents the cylindrical face in the old component. We'll proceed on down to the next bit of geometry, and we need to pick the two faces that represent the tab faces in our width mate. And then finally, when I pick on this mate to be remedied, I can isolate those components again. It shows me who the players are. And here in the preview, it shows me, oh, it's looking for me to pick a face for the tangency mate. And it's super easy to pick the comparable face in the component that is replacing the original one. Everything looks good. I love seeing the green check marks. And when I hit OK, the software does its thing. Our assembly comes back. There are our new gripper fingers. And notice that the replace component command gave me the ability to repair the mates that were broken originally when I replaced that component.